We are aiming to open the Yardway sites on May the 4th and also do the reopening of the Waste and Recycling Center, most specifically what we call the public drop-off or the PDO. We have been working for the past 2 weeks with the ECC and with different departments to make sure we have all the measures in place in order to reopen these sites. Over the next 2 weeks, we're going to be rehiring the seasonal staff that work at the Yardway sites. And we're going to be doing the training required, not only for their normal duties, what they regularly do, but also training relating to COVID in terms of how to handle the situation at the sites and how to maintain the physical distance that we need in order to provide the services. Something that I want to mention that is really important is to still recommend the residents that they only use the sites if they really need to. This is not an opportunity to get out of the house and to go outside only with one bag. Make sure they use the site only when they need to. The sites, they have limitations in terms of how many vehicles we can allocate inside the Yardway sites. Some of the details of the restrictions that are going to be in place with the opening of the sites are they're going to be open Monday to Friday, 9 a.m. until 7 p.m. They will be a self-serve site. With that being said, what it means is that residents will need to unload all the material from their vehicles. Our staff will try not to go there and load the materials because of we want to make sure we maintain the distance. We are also asking residents to put everything into paper bags instead of plastic bags. When they put it into the plastic bag, what happens is that our staff will need to go there and manually debag everything, put the plastic into the garbage. So this will slow down the process. We want to make sure we have a constant flow through the sites. With that also, we're having only one customer at the compactor and one customer at the brand shippers. The idea is to limit the amount of people inside the sites. At the same time, we're going to have one staff at the entrance managing the traffic through the sites. Also, the lineups outside will be managed. We're going to have a safety officer that will be in place in order to make sure we have always the social distance or the physical distance that we require. In terms of the Waste and Recycling Center, the PDO, the site will be open Monday to Friday, 7 a.m. until 5 p.m. The residents will be directed to the Yardway site or the compost area, and we're going to have, on that area, we're going to have a maximum of 2 vehicles unloading at the same time. And it will be on the same premise. It will be a self-serve. So they go through the scale house, they will be directed to the compost area, they can offload there, and they need to do it themselves. In addition, on the public drop-off site, residents will now be allowed again to go to the Waste and Recycling Center and use the hazardous household waste. That means they will be able to dispose of any paint, any electronics, any other materials. And for residents that have excess garbage or yard waste, they also have an option where we have a big area. There will be also signs and cones to delimit the area. And there will be an opportunity to have 2 or 3 residents at the CDO or the PDO at the same time. Regular tipping fees are going to apply. And we're asking all the residents to use a cashless transaction. I mean, it has to be debit or credit. If there are any questions, if people don't know or want to know more about the program, what we want to do is encourage them to call 311, and 311 will be able to have or to answer all the questions they might have.
Yeah, so we had a major fire in our river valley in the Elizabeth Hall wetlands area. The fire is still under investigation, though early indicators believe it's maybe improperly disposed smoking materials. We want to get the message out to folks to really be cautious of their smoking materials. But we had this fire. We responded with 24 of our staff. 3 stations were down there. We worked from approximately, I believe it was right around 3 when it started, and it went on till, well, it's still going on today. Our staff are down there monitoring any of the hot spots as they occur. We knew that it was a large fire. We didn't want it to jump the river or extend any further north or south. We brought in a number of resources. We were able to bring in our mutual aid partners from Colhurst and Coaldale with some wildland trucks to support us. Toll strip construction was very quick to support us, bringing over a bulldozer in case we had to build a fire line, and also some water tenders. The other piece that we called in, which is a little bit unusual for us, is we brought in some resources from Ag and Forestry, and that was the helicopter that everybody saw bucketing water onto the fire. They were on patrol, and they were a short distance away and were able to come in and support us with that fire. Some of the areas where the fire was at, our incident commander, who did an amazing job at the scene, and so did all of our crews, recognized early that to get into where the large portion of that fire was quite hazardous and dangerous to our crews, and the helicopter asset fit that bill perfectly, and they were able to sort of put that area out, minimizing any danger to our crews. Enjoy our River Valley, keep your social distancing. Please don't gather in large groups. But when you're down there, please clean up after yourselves and do watch your, if you're going to smoke, please make sure that you've extinguished all of your smoking materials thoroughly so we don't have any more of these incidents.